Well, we're proposing a techno-prudential set of policies, sort of like we have in global finance right now. It's called macro-prudential. This is the idea that you identify and contain risks to stability, to global stability, that are coming from artificial intelligence, coming from the proliferation of this technology, coming from the disinformation that emerges from chatbots and also can be used and pushed by those that have access to them, but without choking off the innovation opportunities, the enormous wealth, the globalization 2.0 that can come from investing and using AI. So that's the backdrop. That is the challenge. That's what we need to do. And we set up in this piece a set of five principles that we think that any policy, any effective policy in AI has to actually adhere to. And then we talk about what we think some of those institutions should be. First is the precautionary principle, do no harm. Second, these institutions' governance has to be agile because AI is changing so incredibly quickly. And it means that institutions, if they can't reconstitute themselves, if they can't move with the technology, they will be outdated before they're even created. They have to be inclusive. Mustafa and I already hinted at this. When we say that technology companies are sovereign in the space, that means any governance you have is going to have to bring governments and technology corporations together as actors, not just governments by themselves. They have to be impermeable because you can't have slippage. These have to be global. They have to involve the whole supply chain because if you don't govern all of AI globally, given the proliferation of the technology, you're not governing it. And then finally, they need to be targeted. One size will not fit all. You're not going to do all of this with one global institution. There's going to be an entire architecture. So those are our five principles that I think if you want to have any success in the field in governance, Mustafa and I believe you need to adhere to those.